How are you? How about leave the questions to me? The less you have to think, the better. So, how are you? You can be honest. How are you really? Pressure. Last a lifetime. The last thing I want to do is add pressure. There'll be gentle touches around your head, your ears, maybe tucking your hair behind your ears, down your neck, along your nose. And your cheeks, just gentle touches. Don't think too much about it. I don't have to. You can say no. You're allowed to do that. How about if I try it once, and then we go from there? If you dismiss things straight away, you might never find something new you like. So although you can say no, it's nice to say yes sometimes too. But only when it benefits you. How was that? See? Trust me. Just along your face like that. Thank you. facial expression said it all. It's okay. You don't have to worry. When we feel comfort, it's easier when you feel safe to talk about it, to feel it. Sometimes we suppress it, pretend we're okay, and that's okay as well. Sometimes it can be better that way. Feel it. It helps you heal. But again, that has to be done in your own time. Your cheeks. Massaging them a little. Sometimes this can help remove any blockage in your sinus. Obvious. You might not feel it all the time, but it can just relieve some of that pressure in your head. I know. I've asked the question many times, and although I'm getting there slowly, I still don't have the truth. Neither do you. I'm not asking for my benefit. I don't have to know. I want you to feel it. I know you don't want to feel it. I know you're trying your hardest not to. You don't necessarily like to admit. When you're down, maybe you feel a little stupid. Maybe you feel like you might. Everyone is used to you being so jolly, but you feel you might disappoint if you're not. And look, you don't have to admit it openly to me. I am just here to help you yourself to help you feel it, to help you embrace it, to help you use it. You randomly now. Just to see if there is any stress building up around your facial muscles and your head. Of that intense headache you get when you worry too much. Oh yeah, I know. So, how are you? I got a smile. It's very good. That's it. Embrace those thoughts, even if it means you shed a tear or two, even if it means you need a day in bed, even if it means you're not ready to face the world, even if it means you are ready to face the world. Big jump, and it takes a lot of courage when your mind is telling you one thing and then it tells you another. And for some reason we listen. Though to experience all those emotions, it's normal. So no matter how much you beat yourself up about those things, how you could have been better, could have got up earlier, could have done more. Stop it. A break, feel overwhelmed, embrace it, let yourself experience it, good and bad. These moments don't last forever. Look back and think, what were we worried about? Why did it take so long to get over that? Embrace it. Own it. And chase it. Either away, or chase after it because you want it. If you're chasing it away, don't spend too much time. How are you? Patterns with my hands, making sounds to help soothe you. Nothing technical. Just a little trick I picked up. Okay. You're doing well, you know that? You're allowed to be different. If we were all the same, it would be boring. Have all the same jokes, all the same looks. All the same love, all the same hate. Sounds exhausting, doesn't it? Feel better. And again, you can be honest. Has it helped? Your mind off things. I'm sure you're tired now. It's exhausting feeling. But that's the best part about it. The fact that you can feel. And the best part about it is you can heal. Sweet dreams.